What's up, ladies and gentlemen? This is the Prince YouTube PS Compulsion signing in here, aka Prince Anthony. And sorry about my voice. My voice may not sound like 100%. That's because as of right now, I'm like 90%. I did get sick once again. I've just been having a rough past month, bro. Like, literally a rough past month. But anyways, getting that out of the way, ladies and gentlemen, we are in the playoffs and we find ourselves matched up against the Chicago Bulls in the first round. We're the fifth seed. The Chicago Bulls are the sixth seed here on the Charlotte Hornets Mygm 2.0 series. And bro, in that first episode, well, not the first episode, in the first playoff game, which I played in the last episode, which you guys should go ahead and check it out if you missed it. I mean, you can't watch this video without watching the last video. But anyways, in that video or in that game, I honestly thought that we were gonna run right over the Chicago Bulls, but they came out swinging. And bro, we ended up losing game one in the playoffs. So we are down 0-1 against the Bulls, first round of the NBA playoffs. We got to bounce back, bro. But before we get into things, I did say in the last episode I was gonna simulate games 2, 3, and 4, which means if the Chicago Bulls win all three of those games, we are gonna get swept out the playoffs. So I'm keeping my fingers crossed right now that during this simulation we do not get swept, because if we get swept, bro, I'm blowing this whole team up. Everybody on the roster has to go. So before game 2, I made some minor adjustments. Justin Anderson in the starting lineup, and I decided that I want to give Bradley Beal, Malik Monk a break. I did play them in the last episode, but I'm gonna give them a break for game 2. Jerian Grant is out due to injury. Let's see how we do. Okay, so you guys see the game on our schedule. It's time to simulate game 2 of the NBA playoffs, first round against the Bulls. And ladies and gentlemen, we got the W. Let's go. And I think I know the reason why we did get the W. So looking at the box score for game 2, Zach LaVine only played 2 minutes, which means, ladies and gentlemen, he got injured. So I went to look through the Bulls roster and I see that Zach LaVine has a pulled right calf muscle. He's out for the rest of the playoffs. Well, he's out for 6 to 8 weeks, which is basically the rest of the playoffs for the Chicago Bulls, because there is no way they are making it past us in the first round. And even if they make it past us, they are not making it past the second round, bro. That is definitely not gonna happen. So ladies and gentlemen, Zach LaVine out for the remainder of the playoffs, which means we have the edge, bro. If we cannot beat the Bulls in a first round series without Zach LaVine, who was destroying us in game 1, I don't know what to say about this team. So looking at the box score for our squad real quick, D'Angelo Russell putting the team on his back. Steven Adams also had a huge double-double. D'Angelo Russell had a double-double as well. But no Bradley Beal, we got the job done in Chicago, beating the Chicago Bulls. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to shift our focus towards game 3. So we won game 2. Come on. Series is tied at 1 apiece, simulating game 3. Can we please get the W? No, we do not. We take the L to the Chicago Bulls. D'Angelo Russell did his thing once again. Bogey stepped up. No Bradley Beal once again. And this time we could not get the job done. Game 3, big fat L for us. Bro, come on. Like, we beat them in game 2. How can we not beat them in game 3? And looking at the box score for the Chicago Bulls, this is exactly why we didn't beat them for game 3. Lauri Markkanen went off, first off, double-double. But Antonio Blakeney, he went nuts. The dude's like a 72 overall right now on this Mygm series. Dude dropped 31 points on us, 9 three-pointers. How can we let Zach LaVine's backup drop 31 points on our head? I know Blakeney is low-key nice. He is low-key nice. I gotta admit. But 31 points, bro? Come on. Now shifting our focus towards game 4, Bradley Beal. I'm giving him this game off yet again. So game 2, 3, and 4, I'm letting him sit. We definitely need him. But Malik Monk has fully healed from his injury. Ladies and gentlemen, he is going to be back. We need him at the 2. Let's see what's going to happen for game 4. My heart is pounding for this one. You see the game on the schedule. It's time to end the day simulating game 4. Ladies and gentlemen, we get the W. We tie the series. This series is going back, forth, and forth. Series is tied at 2 apiece. D'Angelo Russell doing his thing, leading scorer for our squad once again. Steven Adams did his thing. No Bradley Beal. We get the job done on our home court in Charlotte in front of our fans, bro. Malik Monk didn't have the best game, but listen, he just came back from an injury. That's perfectly fine. But looking at the box score for the Bulls, bro, Blakeney had a pretty decent game. Not as good as his 31-point game the last game, but Otto Porter, leading scorer for the Bulls that game. And now, ladies and gentlemen, shifting our focus to game 5. Now, before I continue, I did say I was simulating game 2, 3, and 4. That's exactly what I did. I am going to be playing through game 5. But before we get to game 5, ladies and gentlemen, 2K hit me with the ultimate disrespect, the ultimate BS. Take a guess what happened. Well, let me show you what happened. The series is tied at 2 apiece. We're getting ready to face off against the Bulls in game 5. I decided to go look at my roster, and I see D'Angelo Russell somehow, someway is hurt. Ladies and gentlemen, D'Lo is injured. 2K hitting me with that BS once again. Luckily, Bradley Beal is healing from his injury, so that's pretty good. But my man D'Angelo Russell, how did he get that injury to begin with? The dude has been balling out for our squad, leading scorer for our team every single game in the playoffs. The dude has been going nuts, and somehow, some way, he gets injured, and the injury is a 1 to 2 week injury. I'm definitely not sitting him out in game 5. I'm sorry, but Bradley Beal, D'Lo, you guys are gonna have to play. This is a huge game for us, because if we win game 5, we take a 3-2 series lead against the Chicago Bulls, and we could possibly close them out on our home court. We have to take this chance. D'Lo, I'm sorry, I know you're injured. Bradley Beal, I'm sorry, I know you're healing from your injury, but both of you guys, you're gonna have to suck it up. You guys are gonna have to play. So now, ladies and gentlemen, we are getting ready here in the United Center, here in Chicago, to face off against the Bulls. Huge game 5. Winner takes a 3-2 series lead. D'Lo back into the starting lineup. Well, he never left the starting lineup, but D'Lo, Bradley Beal back into the starting lineup. Bogey, Dario Saric, Steven Adams. Our squad is ready. Ladies and gentlemen, game 5. It's about to be lit. Ladies and gentlemen, we start this game 5 off with some back and forth action. First, Blakeney taking it to the basket, drawing the foul. First 2 points of the game for the Chicago Bulls. But then look at this. Bradley Beal, perfect release? He's healing from an injury, but getting perfect releases? Let me find out. But then Bulls get the steal. Blakeney all the way to the basket, throwing on the beautiful GGG jam. I gotta give a huge shout out to him. He has been balling out with the absence of Zach LaVine. Bradley Beal knocking down a 3-pointer. Then look at this. Malik Monk faking the jump shot. Nice pass to Noah Vonleh. And then all of a sudden, we started to snatch the momentum from the Chicago Bulls. Look at this. Excellent pass from Malik Monk to the dunk contest champ as Miles Bridges throws down the beautiful jam. And also, Shaquille Harrison all the way to the basket. We got a good lead. Then we start the second quarter with a little bit of a flurry. Look at this. Malik Monk off the pick and roll pull-up jump shot is good. Glad to have him back fully healthy. Then look at that beautiful steal by Harrison in the passing lane, throwing on the beautiful jam. But then, ladies and gentlemen, here comes the BS. So look at this. Malik Monk drives to the basket, right? Draws the foul, gets to the free throw line. First free throw is good for Malik Monk. Second free throw, taking his time, gets it to go. I'm here thinking nothing is wrong. Everything is perfectly fine. And it was up until this point. Malik Monk somehow got caught in an injury animation. It looks like he got caught in like a screen animation or something. I don't know what that was. But then all of a sudden, you see the logo by Malik Monk. The dude somehow, someway gets injured off that play. 2K hitting me with the BS once again. Look at this. Unknown left arm injury for Malik Monk. How does his elbows red? How did it get red? That's what I meant to say. 2K don't want to see me succeed right now, bro. So with Malik Monk now injured, the Chicago Bulls keeping the game closed. Blakeney taking it all the way to the basket, laying it up in there. But here comes Harrison. Yo, he has been balling, bro. He has really been balling off the bench, taking it to the basket, getting the and one. But then Lauri Markkanen throwing it up, getting the shot to go. And then we end the second quarter with a nice drive by Miles Bridges. Now we arrive in the third quarter. And to be honest, I'm starting to get worried. The Bulls low-key starting to get momentum, although we have the lead. You see it right there, Malik Monk. He has an injury. It's going to last for 1 to 2 weeks. I don't know if he's out or if the dude is going to be able to play through the injury. But right now, we are going back and forth. Bradley Beal started balling out in the third quarter. He was like, listen, I'm healing from my injury as well, but I got to put the team on my back right now. The Chicago Bulls just kept on scoring. We just kept going back and forth, literally on every single possession. But then look at this, Bradley Beal to the basket, throwing out the beautiful jam. But then to end the third quarter, the Chicago Bulls hit a three-pointer. It's still a game. So here in the fourth quarter of a pretty close game, Malik Monk, I decided to put him back in the game. He could play through his injury, so right now, I'm sorry, you're going to have to play and play. He did. He gets a wide open three and knocks it down, ladies and gentlemen. Clutch shots while he's injured. But the Chicago Bulls would not go away. Blakeney taking it all the way to the basket, balling off the bench for the Bulls. But then here comes D'Lo kicking it out to the corner. Look at that ball movement. Bradley Beal knocks down the clutch three-pointer. And ladies and gentlemen, somehow, someway, the Chicago Bulls would lose this game. Although we were dealing with Malik Monk getting injured once again. D'Lo was injured. Bradley Beal recovering from injury. We don't have no Jerian Grant. The odds are really stacked against us, and we prevailed with the W. Oh yeah, in addition to Zach LaVine being injured, James Koblin is also injured. Totally forgot to mention that. But looking at the box score for the Chicago Bulls, Antonio Blakeney, again, leading scorer of the game for the Chicago Bulls. They need to play better because this dude, 72 overall, coming off the bench, inserted into the starting lineup because Zach LaVine got injured, is really balling out and putting the Chicago Bulls on his back. Shout out goes to him because he's really holding the team right now, bro. He's really holding the team together. But now looking at the box score for our squad, like I said, a lot of our players are injured. The top three leading scorers for this game for us are injured, bro. Bradley Beal, he dropped 20 points. D'Angelo Russell did his thing. Malik Monk, Harrison off the bench did his thing as well. Perfect team win, perfect team effort behind Bradley Beal. He was just going nuts. He's recovering from an injury, but no excuses, bro. No excuses at all. Bradley Beal, I'm proud of you, bro. And oh yeah, in case you're wondering about Malik Monk, he has a pulled left bicep. 1 to 2 week injury. He is hurt, but he could play through that injury, and that's exactly what he's gonna have to do, because ladies and gentlemen, right now we have a 3-2 series lead with a chance to move on to the second round of the NBA playoffs on our home court in game 6 against Chicago. I'm sorry, but whoever's available to play, whether you're hurt or not, you're gonna have to play. So you see the brackets right there, 3-2 series lead. Like I said, we are gonna leave everything on the court, on our home court. Bradley Beal is playing. I don't care how he feels. Malik Monk is playing. I don't care how he feels. D'Lo, you're playing. Jerian Grant, if he wasn't out, you would definitely be playing. We have a chance to move on to the second round, ladies and gentlemen. I cannot wait because the next episode is definitely going to be lit. So here's what I'm going to do, right? Game 6, I'm going to simulate that game. If we win that game and we move on to the next round, I'm more than likely going to simulate games 1 and 2. Of the next round, because we're not going to have home court advantage, and I want to play on my home court, bro. Like, for this whole playoffs, I didn't get a chance to play in front of our Charlotte Hornets fans. So yeah, I think that would be a good idea. So game 6, if we win that game on our home court, I'm simulating games 1 and 2 in the next round. That way we can play game 3 on our home court. And if we lose game 6 on our home court, and it's a 7-game series against the Chicago Bulls, in the next episode, I am going to play that game 7. Leave everything out on the floor because, come on, I got to give my team a chance to succeed. It's a game 7. Win or go home. I have to play that game, bro. I have to play that game. So the next episode is definitely going to be lit. We're either going to be facing off against the Bulls in a game 7 on the Bulls home court, or we're going to be in the second round facing off either against the Philadelphia 76ers or the Indiana Pacers in game 3, because like I said, I'm simulating game 1 and 2. I want to play on our home court, and playing on our home court in the second round where we wasn't even supposed to make it to the second round, that's fire. I have to do it, bro. So I don't know about you guys, but right now I cannot wait for that next episode. It's definitely gonna be lit. Also, if you made it to the end of this episode, make sure that you leave a like, make sure that you leave a comment, make sure you are subscribed to the channel, because if you made it all the way to the end of this nice playoff victory, this playoff game 5, the end of this episode, and you did not leave a like, you didn't leave a comment, or you're not subscribed to the channel, that's some real shady business. But if you did, do all three of those things, and you made it to the end, guess what? You are loved, you are appreciated, and best of all, you're the real MVP. So I'll see you guys next time. Make sure you click one of the playlists on the screen. Check out some of my other videos because my content in general is lit. Thank you guys once again for watching. This is the Prince of YouTube, signing out.